Good morning all of you. In this video session we will study alkalinity of water, types of alkalinity and how alkalinity of water samples can be determined and their calculation part. So let's begin with our session, alkalinity of water sample. What is exactly meant by the alkalinity of water sample? Alkalinity of water, it is an ability of water to neutralize the acid is known as what? Alkalinity of water. Basically, alkalinity is due to presence of what? Hydroxide, carbonate and bicarbonate salt of calcium, magnesium and sodium. There are three different types of the alkalinity. Which one? Carbonate alkalinity, bicarbonate alkalinity and hydroxide type of the alkalinity, right? See, alkalinity of water, it is mainly due to presence of what? Hydroxide. Example of hydroxide salt is sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, right? These are the examples of hydroxide salt. Second example is bicarbonate, calcium bicarbonate, sodium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate. These are the bicarbonate salt. And third one is carbonate salt. Which is the carbonate salt? Calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate, sodium carbonate. So these all are the responsible for the alkalinity of water. So alkalinity, it is an ability of water to neutralize the acid is known as alkalinity of water. And alkalinity, it is due to presence of only three salt: hydroxide, carbonate and bicarbonate. Due to this, your water becomes what? Alkaline in nature. Then the theory behind this: when the alkaline water is titrated with strong acid, first of all hydroxide get neutralized, right? In presence of what? Your phenolphthalein. And then all carbonate ion are gets half neutralized to the what? Bicarbonate. And the end point is what? Till the stage of the pH of mixture is decreased near about 8.2 and there is a completion of this stage indicated by change in color of what? Phenolphthalein indicator, right? So for determination of alkalinity of water, we can use phenolphthalein indicator as well as methyl orange indicator. Phenolphthalein indicator gives the pink color with hydroxide and carbonate, and methyl orange gives yellow color in presence of hydroxide, carbonate and bicarbonate, right? So on continue addition of acid during the titration, all bicarbonate in the titration mixture get neutralized, and completion of this stage indicated by methyl orange color changes at about 4 to 5 pH. So methyl orange endpoint is what? Yellow to orange red. So here is what? Here is complete neutralization of hydroxide, complete neutralization of carbonate and complete neutralization of bicarbonate in presence of what? Your methyl orange indicator, right? And in phenolphthalein indicator, the endpoint of titration is what? That is pink to colorless. So in this case, only complete neutralization of hydroxide and 1/2 neutralization of carbonate is going to take place. See, the reaction is like this: hydroxide plus H plus ion converted into what? H2O. Then carbonate plus H plus ion converted into what? Bicarbonate. So in this case, phenolphthalein alkalinity, it is due to presence of what? Complete neutralization of hydroxide ion and 1/2 neutralization of what? Carbonate ion, right? Then in next stage, bicarbonate plus H plus converted into what? H2O plus CO2. So in this methyl orange, the end point is what? Yellow color changes to orange red. So here is complete neutralization of hydroxide, carbonate and bicarbonate. Now the combination of alkalinity present in water sample is only hydroxide alkalinity, only carbonate alkalinity, only bicarbonate alkalinity, hydroxide carbonate together, carbonate bicarbonate together. These are the possible combination present in your water sample, but not hydroxide and bicarbonate alkalinity together. Why hydroxide and bicarbonate alkalinity not together? Because hydroxide and bicarbonate combine together and again it is converted into a carbonate. That's why hydroxide and bicarbonate alkalinity, this is the possible combination, is not present in your water sample. Or sometimes question may be asked like this, why carbonate can be titrated in presence of methyl orange indicator as well as in presence of the phenolphthalein indicator? Because by addition of phenolphthalein indicator, carbonate is get half neutralized. So carbonate plus H plus gives converted into what? Bicarbonate in presence of what? Phenolphthalein indicator. Then the remaining converted bicarbonate again neutralized, converted into what? H2O plus CO2. There is a complete neutralization in presence of what? Methyl orange. Therefore, carbonate can be titrated in presence of phenolphthalein as well as in presence of what? Methyl orange indicator. The procedure is very simple. First of all, prepare a alkaline water sample, okay, and that alkaline water samples containing hydroxide, carbonate and bicarbonate compound, right? Now take volume of above alkaline water sample in conical flask. Suppose measure 20 ml alkaline water sample in conical flask. To this add 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Then color of solution becomes what? Pink color. Then titrate this pink color sample against standard strong acid, either hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid. The end point of titration is pink color changes to what? Colorless. So note down, this is what your V1 ml burette reading. So V1 indicate that burette reading up to phenolphthalein end point. So here is what? Complete neutralization of hydroxide and 1/2 neutralization of carbonate. That is what your phenolphthalein end point V1 ml burette reading. Then in same conical flask, add 2 to 3 drops of methyl orange indicator, right? Then color of solution becomes what? Yellow. So titrate this yellow color solution against standard acid. The end point of titration is yellow color changes to what? Orange red. Note down, this is V2 ml burette reading. So what is V2 ml burette reading? This is the end point of what? Your methyl orange indicator. Means what? There is a complete neutralization of hydroxide, carbonate and bicarbonate. So this is what your V2 ml burette reading. So from this experiment we can calculate V1 and V2. Okay. Now calculation part is very simple. Phenolphthalein alkalinity, which is equal to what? V1 divided by V into Z into 50 into 1000 ppm calcium carbonate equivalent. So by using this formula we can calculate phenolphthalein alkalinity. Methyl orange alkalinity can be calculated by V2 divided by V into Z into 50 into 1000 ppm calcium carbonate equivalent. So what is the V1? V1 is called as burette reading up to phenolphthalein end point, right? Then V2 is also called as what? Burette reading up to methyl orange end point during the titration. Z is the normality of acid, standard acid, sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid. 50 is the equivalent weight of what? Your calcium carbonate. And 1000 is the constant factor. So by using this formula we can calculate the phenolphthalein alkalinity as well as methyl orange alkalinity present in your water sample. See, these are the possible combinations of alkalinity present in your water sample. If the phenolphthalein alkalinity is zero, right? So there is only bicarbonate type of alkalinity is present, means methyl orange type of alkalinity is present. If phenolphthalein alkalinity, which is equal to methyl orange alkalinity, then only hydroxide quantities are present. Carbonate and bicarbonate is zero. If phenolphthalein is equal to 1/2 ml, then only carbonate and bicarbonate are present. So carbonate formula is 2p. 2p means what? 2 into phenolphthalein alkalinity. From this we can calculate carbonate type of the alkalinity. If p is greater than 1/2 ml, then only carbonate and bicarbonates are present. Formula for carbonate is which is equal to 2P, means 2 into phenolphthalein alkalinity, and bicarbonate is M minus 2P, means methyl orange alkalinity minus 2 into phenolphthalein alkalinity. And if P is less than 1 half M or greater than 1 half M, then only hydroxide carbonate and carbonate bicarbonate, this type of possible combinations of alkalinities are present. Okay, so I hope that you understood the whole concept of alkalinity of water and how the alkalinity of water samples can be determined. Okay, so thank you very much.